Jesus died not only to make a provision for our forgiveness and our justification. We could be new men and women in Christ, that we could live a new life. Now, in Romans 6, when it tells us how to experience that, it gives us three key words. He says, I need to know the facts, Romans 6:6. And the second key word, which I'm going to develop a little bit more here today, is the in verse 11, where he says, continually consider, continually reckon, continually count yourself to be dead to sin and alive to God. He says, I want you to view yourself that way. See yourself as a winner in the spiritual realm. Now, my fourth grade teacher made a tremendous impact upon my life. I was actually an adult before I realized what that lady had done for me. As I go back, that's many, many years ago, obviously, but there was a little bit of special insecurity in my life as I walked into that fourth grade class. My second grade teacher, who was a beautiful lady fresh out of college, in my mind, and I hope my perception was wrong, but in my mind, my perception was she viewed me as a problem. I can still remember the words when she came and the class came back from the playground and she entered the classroom. I remember the words out of her mouth. I bet that Bill Thrasher did that. I actually had not done it that time. since she viewed me as a problem, I have a wonderful older brother. He's 2 years older. He's been a wonderful big brother. And he was kidding me, not realizing how seriously I was taking the kidding. But in that period, second grade, third grade, he came to me and he said, you know, Bill, I think it'd be very wise for us to take some of those, just some of those standardized tests for you. He says, I'm not sure you have all your marbles up there, so I think it'd just be good to know. Oh, you don't think I do? Well, I was taking it far more seriously than his joking nature that he realized. Well, anyhow, I walk into the fourth grade class, you know, since my previous teacher looked at me as a problem, and since my brother doesn't think I have all my marbles out there. But dear Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Peterson, it may be that if you would look at her, most people would not have looked at her as an attractive lady. She became one of the most beautiful people in the world to me. Because Mrs. Peterson, at least my perception was, she believed in me. She thought I could do the best academically, and you know, I did from that moment on. I was an adult before I realized that. I remember sharing that with my mother, and she said, oh, I don't think moms and dads wanted their sons in Mrs. Peterson's class. Well, when I learned that, I went out of my way to try to call and contact Mrs. Peterson. I was not able to do it. I called every Peterson in the Montgomery, Alabama phone book, and I was not able to get her. And finally, I realized where she had moved to, so I got that information, but I called there, and it was an unlisted number. So I said, God, would you tell Mrs. Peterson the amazing thing that she did for me? Well, how you view yourself will affect how you live. God wants you to see yourself the way he sees you, as a winner in the spiritual realm. Like I say, as we said in the previous session, it's not just pretending something to be true. It's not trying to make something be true. It is true. There's the story of the eagle whose egg was dropped in the nest of a prairie chicken. And the eagle grew up thinking it was a prairie chicken. And so it would fly just a few feet off the ground. It would scratch in the dirt for seeds and insects, and because that's what a prairie chicken was supposed to do. Well, one day, the eagle who had grown up with the prairie chicken saw this beautiful, amazing bird in the sky, and turned to his neighbor and said, what's that? Oh, that's the chief of the birds. That's an eagle. As it was soaring high in the sky. But his neighbor said, never give it another thought. You're a prairie chicken. And so he never gave it another thought. And it died thinking it was a prairie chicken. It was built to soar into the heavens and be an eagle. But it was conditioned to be a prairie chicken. Well, the God says, I want you, relating to that illustration, consider yourself to be an eagle and not a prairie chicken, because that's really who you are. God says, I want you to see yourself for who you are. As we'll talk later, it takes courage to really agree with God and say, Lord, I thank you. Out of your sheer grace, you have made me a winner in the spiritual realm. Praise God for that. Thank God for that. And Lord, I praise you that you're going to train me to live in light of that. And we pray that in Jesus' name. Lord, thank you. Communicate this concept, Lord, to your people across our land. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen.